What's happening, people? We're out and about again. I am just currently having a little rest because I've been walking for about an hour and a half. I've got a bit of a sweat on. Been walking to the place where I'm going today from my house. So it's a few miles. I'm not sure exactly how many miles, but you know, doing a bit of exercise before I tuck into this mega mixed grill, because that's what I'm going for. I love a mixed grill. I love the variation on a mixed grill. You get all the different kinds of meats. You get onion rings, tomatoes. That is probably one of my favourite pub classic meals. Obviously, sometimes you want something a bit lighter, but this will be the only meal I eat today. It's currently nearly 12 o'clock, and we're going to a Sizzler's pub. So I believe that this mixed grill is £13.99, but we'll check when we get in there. And the pub I'm going to today is called the Armitage Arms. Now, it is been here for as long as I can remember. I'm in a little town called Clifton, which is just overlooking Brighouse. I'll just spin you around now. And you can see some of the views. So just at the end of this road is the Armitage Arms. So it's a nice day, although it does look a little, on the camera there, it looks a little bit grey, but it's a bit grey, but it's a nice day. It's warm. I'm hoping to sit outside. They do have a nice little beer garden area where they let you serve, they let you eat your food, I'm told. So we'll go in, we'll have a little look around, and yeah, and we'll get us food ordered. I'll just have two more minutes on this bench. Come on then, let's go. Okay, so it's actually called a sizzling pub, not a sizzler's pub. So I made a mistake. I wasn't far off. I'm closer than I normally am. We are here now, the Armitage Arms Sizzling Pub and Grill. So, as always, I film the B-roll and things like that, the inside, after I've eaten, because I don't want them to give me anything that you don't normally get, if that makes sense. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in, undercover, order my mixed grill, we'll go out the back, and I'll see you at the table. Okay, so I have been in and ordered. I have gone for the Ultimate Mixed Grill. It is on their Ultimate Plates section of the menu. Mega Mixed Grill, sorry, not an Ultimate Mixed Grill. It's £13.99. 5 ounce rump steak, 7 ounce gammon steak, grilled chicken fillet, 2 pork sausages, grilled tomato, mushrooms, onion rings, and skin on fries. Now, she did ask me if I wanted salad, normal chips, or skin on fries. I just went as it comes. Skin on fries is fine for me, so that's what we'll have. And she asked me if I wanted sauces: béarnaise sauce, peppercorn sauce, beef dripping sauce. So I went for the beef dripping sauce, something I don't think I've had before. So hopefully that is really, really nice. We are sat near the road, which is not ideal, but I should be okay with getting rid of the background noise. Anyway, you guys have a look at this menu. Bring on the sizzler. Okay, so what would you go for from that menu? You'll have to let me know in the comments. If I'd have come at 12 o'clock, half an hour earlier, I could have got two mains for £11.75, which is quite interesting, isn't it? All your little pubs classics. Maybe, if this is nice, I come back up with Mrs. Dino and we have a two mains for £11.75. Yeah, she won't walk up though. I did get a fresh orange lemonade. My total bill was £18.49. So I think the sauce must have been extra. I didn't ask, I just paid. I didn't get a receipt. Maybe not though, maybe that would just be the difference in price. I think I've been rumbled here. Okay, so I got rumbled filming, but that was because the food has arrived. So you guys have a gander at this and then we'll get stuck in. Let me tell you, this looks unbelievable. Really, really nicely charred. And they're called a sizzle pub, aren't they? Sizzling pub. So you'd expect this. Look at this tomato. That is how you want a fresh tomato. Unbelievable. You know, I'm going to start with the tomato because that is right up my street, that. Look at this. Oh. Wow, falling away. You know me, guys, can be fussy when it comes to tomatoes, but that is spectacular. Right, now we'll get back to what I normally do. We'll start with a sausage. Looks like it's got some herbs in this sausage, but once again, look at them griddle marks on that banger. Wow, let's have a look inside. It didn't specify whether it's Cumberland, Lincolnshire, pork and leek, or anything like that, but let me tell you, it's got a nice snap on the outside, nicely charred, and it looks pretty damn good, I'll be honest. Oh, wow. Wow, it tastes like a Cumberland. Unbelievable. Wow, these mushrooms look a bit too clean for me, a bit not dirty enough, or they're a bit dry. I like it when they're swimming in their own juices. Got a nice flavour, but they're a bit dry then. Like I said, I went for fries. Nice fries, they're not empty, they've got potato in them, really nice. Crispy, come with like peppered. I've got like seasoning on. They just come with salt and pepper and vinegar, they actually don't need it. Onion rings, you get three onion rings, go with fingers for this one. Thin, very thin onion rings. very crispy batter, as always, with proper onion rings. The actual onion can come right out. You know if it's a store-bought onion ring because it's a bit more mashy, and when you bite it, it don't come out. But this crispy batter, look at that. It's nice. A little bit of beef dripping gravy. So, get a fry, dip it, oh, it's, look at that. This should be absolutely delightful. Oh, that is rich. That is a rich, wow, that is so rich, that gravy, that beef flavour. It's nice though. Wow. Right, chicken breast, look at this. Look at that chicken breast, wow. And that is both sides. This is proper being sizzled. These are living up to the name, the sizzling pub, sizzle pub. It is so far, yes, thank you. Wow, look at that. They, of course, know I'm filming now. Oh. Oh. That. I love mixed grills, and I love, like, this charcoaled. I mean, some people might say it's a bit burnt for them. Some people don't like that taste, but that. If you're getting a grill, this is what you want. Wow. That is beautiful, tender chicken, but on the outside. On the outside, it's like proper griddled bit of beef dripping gravy on the chicken. Why not? Oh, wow. This might be the best mixed grill I've ever had. Right. Let's get onto the steak. I asked for this steak cooked medium rare. Does look a little bit overdone from medium rare, but that might just be the griddling on the outside. Let's cut into it and see if it's medium rare. I tell you what's missing, you don't get an egg on this mixed grill. On some mixed grills, you get an egg. Yeah, I think that's a little bit overdone. So, for medium rare, although it looks a little bit pinker on the camera. We'll give it a go anyway. It's nice and it's cutting up very easily. Look at that. It's probably more medium, but it's really tasty. Oh, I don't know actually. DJI Mic 2 transmitter storage full. I don't know what's going on with the mic. It might have. Anyway, we'll carry on. This. It's got a built-in mic. Okay, look at that. So it's actually probably is medium rare. Medium in places, rare in places. I'm gonna get it in this beef dripping. Oh. Wow. Oh my days. Right, okay. You've got this huge, I think it's 7 ounce piece of gammon. Look at that. Obviously, same as the chicken and the steak, you've got them nice griddle marks. It's cutting nice and easy. Look in there. Nice piece of gammon. Let's give it a. Oh, yeah. My nice crunchy charred edges. Oh. A nice salty piece of gammon. Mrs. Dino would love this. This is what she'd get. Wow. This is all so good. Wow. This could be the best I've ever had. The fries, although they were fries, they did say I could get chips. They didn't mention chunky chips, but if we can get chunky chips, maybe this would have been the best ever. But these fries are nice. They're not they're not like skaggy ends. They're tasty. They've got lots of potato in them. And obviously, when you can dip it in the beef dripping, although they're nicely seasoned on their own. Wow. Wow. This is really, really nice. Right. I'm going to finish this. Don't go anywhere, because I'm going to tell you what the next video is going to be, and you guys that have been waiting for something for a while, you should enjoy this one. But for now, I'm going to get this beef dripping gravy on these chips. And on the steak. Plenty of it as well. And I'm going to finish my dinner. And give it a score. And you probably already realise it's going to be a big one. Wow.
Okay, so that was the Armitage Arms, the sizzling pub. And let me tell you, that mixed grill was sizzling. As close to a perfect mixed grill for my taste as you can probably get. The steak was done perfect. I actually thought it was a bit overdone for me, but once I started eating it and cutting into it, it was done perfect. Really, really nice chicken breast, really good griddle marks on all the meats, sausage, beautiful Cumberland sausage, tomato, wow, I even started with the tomato, didn't I? Absolutely banging tomato. That is how a fresh tomato should be cooked. I'm going to give it a 9.9. I think the only thing I'd say bad is maybe the mushrooms were a bit drier than I'd like them. I like them a bit more greasier, but that's just like a personal preference, isn't it? They were tasty, and maybe chunky chips, but they did offer me chips, so I just got it as it came with skin on fries, so that's obviously my fault. I mean, I were never getting the side salad. But, yeah, overall, it was really, really tasty. Like I said earlier in the video, I'm going to give you a little sneak peek of the next video on the channel. And the next video on the channel is going to be a budget video, a budget challenge. So you guys have been asking for it for a while. It's supposed to pee down tomorrow, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to head down to the place where I'm doing it from. And yeah, I'm not going to give you too much information, but make sure you subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. We're on the road to 14,000 now. So keep building, keep going. The out and abouts are going to continue, but for the next video, it's going to be a budget food challenge. You've been asking for it, so I deliver it. Thanks for watching this. Take care, and I'll catch you on the next one. Oh, and if you want me to go back there and try the two meals for $11.75, what were on the menu, let me know, and I'll take Mrs. Dino up and, yeah, we'll have another little go up there. It's really nice. They also do breakfast up there, so I wonder what that's like. Catch you on the next one. Bye-bye. Also, I realised that I didn't show you the inside of the pub. I've totally forgot. I've got all the way down the hill. Apologies. Normally I do the B-roll after I've eaten the food and things, because I don't want them to know I'm filming, like I said earlier. But in this instance, I forgot. Sorry. I'll definitely take Mrs. Dino back and I'll show you inside a pub in a future video. See you later.